Hello, before I get to the main point of the video, I want to say a few words about this picture of Metropolitan Demetrius. Notice how his head is slightly turned to the right. He's not looking directly into the camera. I think that this pattern comes from the non-Christian world that is actually pagan. You might see a portrait of an emperor or a king or royalty having pictures like this with their head slightly turned. This is not a Christian concept. It's worldly and it's vain, okay? What's wrong with looking directly into the camera? You're not being a bad person if you look directly into the camera. See, by looking directly in the camera, you're demonstrating humility, and for that moment, you're admitting that you are subject to the person who's taking the photo, and that requires humility. So I think having your head slightly turned is arrogant, it's vain. They're promoting themselves like they're royalty or something, and this does not come from Christianity. This is a pagan concept, okay? And let me see here. What's the purpose of even having a picture taken of a bishop in the first place? What purpose does it serve? There's absolutely no reason for it. Just because our society creates these things like cameras does not mean we all have to use them. I just think that taking pictures is not necessary. It's vain, and this picture to me seems so vain, okay? And I think it's a pagan concept, you know, that ancient, I don't know really if ancient, but maybe hundreds of years ago, people who were in royalty, maybe emperors and kings, they had portraits drawn of them with their heads slightly turned as if they're something great. And it just seems vain, and it's not Christian, it's not humble. You're not being a bad Christian if you look directly into the camera. And why even take, as I say, why even have photos taken of you in the first place? Christianity is all about Christ. We don't want to draw attention to ourselves. Now I'll get to the main point of my video. Actually, I want to say a few more words here about this picture. In Orthodox Christianity, we are to emulate the saints, okay? And if you look at icons, the saints are always looking directly at you. See, these are our models. These are deified and sanctified human beings. So if you're going to have your picture taken, why don't you emulate the saints in this regard? Why don't you copy their pattern of looking directly at the person? See, so what Demetrius has done here, and what, if any other bishops have these kind of pictures taken, I know of one other bishop that has his picture taken. He's not looking directly in the camera. His head is slightly turned away. What they're doing is they have departed from the saints in this regard. We are to follow the saints' example, so why not look at the person like the saints do in their icons? Okay, so this practice that I'm talking about with the head turn does not come from sanctified people. It does not come from holy people. It comes from the pagan world. Now I will get to my main point. Hello, I want to talk about Metropolitan Demetrius of the GOC. He's the new Metropolitan because Pavlos retired. And Demetrius is another example of betrayal, okay? It's almost as if it has become official policy that they will only consecrate people who are traitors, basically. Now, the only good thing Demetrius has done is stop the 2002 encyclical violations, which I protested for years. But according to Bishop Sergius Black's warped logic, Demetrius can no longer go to a GOC church because he is against the GOC giving communion to heretics. So this is the logical implication if one were to take Sergius's statement seriously. See, he pushed me out of his church, Sergius Black, because I was against the 2002 encyclical violations. He said, since I'm against the GOC giving community heretics, it would not be good for me to be in a church I believe to be heretical. But I didn't claim the GOC was heretical. I simply protested the clergy's disobedience to the 2002 encyclical. Now, even Father Maximus of the GOC told me that Bishop Sergius's reason was false. He said most of their people are against their clergy giving communion to heretics, and he said Bishop Sergius will have to answer to God for this. Okay, so if we followed Sergius's warped reasoning through consistently, it would mean that most of the people in the GOC that Father Maximus referenced, including Father Maximus and including Demetrius, can no longer attend GOC parishes, which is ludicrous. Okay, so this is ridiculous. So Demetrius stopped the 2002 encyclical violations, which I'm happy about, but there are at least two other problems with this man that I am aware of. He went along with the union with the Senate and resistance people, and this is outrageous. Demetrius came from the Hakna, which is known for writing that famous book, The Struggle Against Ecumenism, which in no uncertain terms denounces Metropolitan Cyprian of Philae, the founder of the pseudo-Senate and resistance. So apparently this doesn't mean anything to Demetrius anymore. He just goes right along with the union with the Senate and resistance. The Senate and resistance hasn't changed their positions, and they're deposed, uncanonical, schismatics, and heretics, and anathematized by the Old Calendar Church of Greece. But apparently this doesn't mean anything to Demetrius. So my personal opinion is that the temptation to be made a metropolitan was just too powerful for this man. He just wanted to be a metropolitan, so he was willing to compromise what he believed so he can be in a high position of authority and power. This is my personal belief. I do believe a lot of these men are in their positions for their own vanity, and they're willing to sacrifice what they believe in order to be in high positions of authority. See, and these are the kind of men that are being consecrated and ordained today, and that's why you will never in your lifetime see a perfectly united Old Calendarist church, because in order for them to unite into one church, somebody's going to have to admit wrongdoing. They're going to have to make sacrifices. They're going to actually have to be consistent. And these things are just not possible with these kind of people, these kind of characters. They're of bad will. They want to be in leadership positions. They want their own jurisdictions for their own vanity. They want to acquire wealth. And they will even have, this is actually another problem with Demetrius. There's actually three problems that I know of here. They will even have corrupt bishops in their jurisdictions, even if the clergy and bishops are disqualified according to the canons. Because see, they've got to have as many bishops as possible to build up their jurisdiction. So they will even have disqualified bishops if it suits their purposes. They strain at gnats and swallow camels. Okay, so, you know, there are at least three bishops that I know of in the GOC that are disqualified according to the canons. And I informed Demetrius about this, and nothing is going to be done about these men because they've got to have as many bishops as possible to build their jurisdiction for their own vanity. See, straining at gnats, swallowing camels, and they're not consistent. They'll violate the canons and the teaching of the church when and if it suits their purposes. One of these bishops is Sergius Black. He's disqualified pursuant to Apostolic Canon 52 for what he did to me. He also pushed three families away. And Apostolic Canon 52 says he is to be deposed for this. See? Let me see. Also, Metropolitan Moses, a homosexual. There are several canons which denounce this man. And, you know, the GOC doesn't care, though. See, they'll violate, you know, their own encyclical if it suits their purposes. They'll violate the canons if it suits their purposes. Moses is disqualified according to the canons of the Orthodox Church. Okay, because he was involved sexually for many years with Father Panteleimon. These men have no fear of God. It doesn't bother them to violate the canons if it suits their purposes. See, they don't have fear of God. These kind of men should not be consecrated. The other bishop is Christodoulos. According to, I think it's Apostolic Canon 27, he is to be deposed. Apostolic Canon 27 says a clergyman is to be deposed simply for striking a person with their hand. Bishop Christodoulos actually hit a homeless man in the face with a shovel, people. This is outrageous. And the man's name was Marinius. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing his name correctly. But he sued the GOC, and the GOC settled out of court for this. Now, they're trying to sweep this under the rug and make it seem like it's an insignificant thing, but he's deposed according to that canon. And if I were a bishop and I had that kind of manifestation of hitting a person in the face with a shovel, I would on my own accord feel totally unworthy and step down. But these men have high views of themselves and low views of the rules of Orthodoxy. See, they're in their positions for their own vanity, I believe. He's deposed Christodoulos according to that canon, Apostolic Canon 27, I think it is. See, and Demetrius has not done anything about this. And so these are the reasons why these men are disqualified, okay? Another bad thing about Demetrius is that I reported to him in a kind manner. In fact, I even read the letter that I wrote him and made a video on it. I reported him with Bishop Curtis Blackie, and he did absolutely nothing about it, people. These are corrupt people. Bishops should defend the rights of the sheep of Christ's flock. See, these men are all cut from the same cloth. They're all corrupt. They violate the teachings of Orthodoxy when and if it suits their purposes. And if they, when they realize that you're not going to go along with their policy, it seems, of hypocrisy and violating the rules of their own church, in this case the 2002 encyclical, they'll just ruthlessly, like cold mechanical robotic psychopaths, just drop you off on the side of the road like you never existed, and may even slander you like Pavlos of Astoria did with Archbishop Gregory of Colorado. So these men are all cut from the same cloth. They're all not true shepherds. They have all violated New Testament teaching on the responsibilities of shepherds and how they are to govern their flocks. These men are fake. And I don't think I could state it any other way, people. I've proven my arguments, I've cited sources, and I just don't know what else to do here. So I asked myself a long time ago, would a church or religion that treats me this way be from God? The answer is an unequivocal no, people. This is not the true church. It's not the true religion. It's not the true faith. These men are incompetent spiritually. And there's more information below in the description box. I thank you for listening.